are you?
Yeah. It's so nice. It's warm.
Yeah, it is.
No wind. It's like.
It's very nice.
And it's March. I mean, my friends in New York are like still buried in 3 feet of snow.
Yeah.
Oh, look at that beautiful ground.
I went.
This old Overo Bay mayor, who's a top 10 world finalist on the jumper. I learned a lot because of her good performance and genes, obviously. And that, along with genetics, too.
It's way back.
And the other one, the baby, kind of crowd and dominate everything. And plus he feels kind of odd and kind of out. And so the crowd is closed. So I do feed her separately, that helps. She has her own stall. So, hi everyone. And
the horses, you think, are in a shamanic way, or have a healing?
Every time I think I know at which level they operate, they operate at a deeper level, and it's really the best analogy I have is the shamanic beings. And since I think the last time we met, we got an email from a friend about there's a healing method called heart math, and I'm not going to get bogged down into details, but one thing they did is measure the electric field around the human heart, and it goes about 8 feet out from us, which is, you know, why you feel comfortable around some people and other people give you the heebie-jeebies.
Right.
You're feeling their field. And the horse's field, with the same measurement, is 5 or 7 times as big. I think personally it's even bigger than that. But being in the heart field of the horse, I think that's one way in which they shamanically connect with us and allow us to, I don't know how else to say it, just untie old knots, you know, old wounds sort of gently come to the surface and then we can let them go.
Right.
The sleeping brigade.
The sleeping brigade.
Never see that.
The sun. And the sun rises. And she asks her grandfather, you know, seriously, do you mean to tell me that the sun would not have come up? And yes, the sun would not have come up. A gaseous ball would have appeared in the sky and warmed the disk, but fun. That's a human experience.
So I have a little thing here, since we're, you know, in the process, everyone, of working on the relationship with the horse that will lead to the ride. And the
right.
Horse and I were relaxed and living. Did we both respect each other's personal space?
Yeah.
Did I remain calm at all times, and did we both start and finish on a positive and peaceful note?
Very important.
So that's 7 things.
It's just like with people.
Things that go up to me is understanding who he is, what he is, some of the stuff in the past. What he told us, he does have some physical issues. But remember, he has the physical problem too, because he not only was sold 5 different times,
walk.
Okay.
Yeah.
They're relaxed. Coming back to homeostasis.
Great.
You know, trying to pull it to you.
Okay.
So you started by saying you wanted to get to know him better, right?
Right.
So do you feel any change from last time as far as...
I think he's more relaxed.
Does seem to be, doesn't he?
I think they do.
Oh, absolutely. If he's not aloof, he's not active. Mama and the end of the other end of the...
Right, he was...
He's right here with us.
Two or more
So when you're ready, why don't we put the halter on and see how he responds today? Nate, do you want to smoke? Okay, so Ron is going to walk Nate now. See how he does. Yep, just be careful that you, there we go, that you're on the outside for safety in case he moves off. And the command is walk on. Give him a little more head and be in front of him and invite him with your hand. Invite him with an open hand to come follow you. There you go. So you're encouraging and never pulling. It's drawing him towards you. There we go. Good boys. And if he stops for a minute, we got to give him a minute to think. He's kind of looking around in the environment. So bring him around, be a little bit more assertive, bring his head back around. There you go, and bring around this way. Keep coaxing him, very good. Now sometimes if one thing doesn't work, Ron, it's good to do another. So you might want to try crossing over in front of him with this hand in and bringing him around towards you. Walk on, Nate, walk on. See how we're doing there? Bringing him this way. So in other words, changing directions. Coming this way, coming that way.
Okay.
Very good. And he's stopping and thinking. Come this way, yeah, with an open hand, bringing him this way. Walk on, there we go. Coaxing him with that hand. Oh, sorry, Ron, this is all the mud. We'll run you in the mud.
No, I don't want to get
here we go.
In between the fence and
the right, there you go. Go. We've exposed him.
So how can you reassure him and at the same time remind him
kind of entrenching in his anxiety, isn't
he? I think you ought to make it.
What are you and Leah doing? I think you
What are some other steps that we could take? In other words, I believe in the problem-solving idea of trying something these three different ways. So what are some different ways we might be able to instill in this guy some movement and movement where he then can learn and build on that, that it's okay? Because he is definitely pushing back, isn't he? Yep. He's becoming entrenched there. Yeah, he hasn't run off. He's still with you. Just not responding to the lead on the road. That's a no. Even though he popped his head up and down, that's a no. Go back to what we're with him. And it's all okay. We don't worry about what happens. We don't cling to it. We just be aware of it.
Oh, I
see. Your life isn't that interesting to rule, so.
Zeke, our dog's life. That's not interesting.
Really thoroughly.
Oh, yeah.
You're
dead.
Yeah.
Animals,
you better.
Right.
There we go. Florian, yay!
Hey, all right, Florian. Terrific. Yeah.
It's okay. On it. There we go. I got all three of you in there. That's great. There we go.
After I take a bath, they conceived our dog. Lick me. That's a new smell.
And that's how we always want to end it, just like that. Positive and peaceful note. And loving. Very good, folks. Very good.
So until next time, bye now.
When?
Right, so we will be back with Florian and
when?
And the horses on the 3rd of April.
Well, I don't think